Superstation TBS, the home of the Goodwill Games, and we're going to...
Goodwill.
And we got some...
That's where you get your suits at. Oh, I'm sorry. That's another
thing. I used to get them there.
I'm sorry.
I don't get them there anymore.
I shouldn't say that.
This is a great city. We've had fun here today. I like Cleveland.
Fun in Cleveland. You know, Cleveland is the home of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
I know that.
Name a famous rock and roll singer from Cleveland.
I got one.
Huh?
I got one.
Who?
Don King.
Don King?
Yeah.
A famous rock and roll singer.
I was thinking of a soul thing, no.
Eric Carmen. Eric Carmen, famous rock and roll star from Cleveland, Ohio. As a matter of fact, the only rock and roll star from Cleveland, Ohio. Wasn't Eric one of your favorites?
Back in when? The 60s?
Well.
I don't remember him.
Eric
short-term memory loss on my
Eric
part,
Eric Carmen
though.
Was very famous. But, you know, they want to build the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame here in Cleveland, and they want Cleveland to pay for it, but they want the induction ceremonies in New York. They haven't been able to come up with enough money to get any rock and roll stars to fly in here.
Well, the Cuban Assassins come up with enough money.
We're going to fly out of here.
And, we're going to fly out and see Tommy Wildfire Rich and the Cuban Assassins next.
This match is a 1-4 with a 30-minute time. And introducing from Havana, Cuba, the Cuban Assassin. And his opponent now making his way to the ring area. From Atlanta, Georgia, ladies and gentlemen, this is Wildfire Tommy Rich.
Oh, yeah. Do you want a party with Hank Jr. and Wildfire Tommy Rich?
I got sugar for my blues and a gun for my hand. Lord, it's hard to be
as Bo Cephas sings in the background. You can tell that southern influence that Tommy Rich possesses. Bo Cephas emblem even on the back of his jacket. And this rowdy friend has made his way to the squared circle to take on the double tough Cuban Assassin here on World Championship Wrestling, but that's this Saturday night at 6:05. This is the Power Hour, of course. Still to come, our big main event for the United States Heavyweight Championship, Lex Luger. And the outstanding youngster, one of my favorite competitors, Brad Armstrong. And if Luger is the least bit overconfident tonight, he is going to be in big, big trouble because Brad Armstrong is ready. I talked to him before we went on the air. He is ready to go. This is the match of his life as far as he's concerned. Tommy Rich wants that United States Heavyweight Championship as well. Many of the fans are familiar with his abilities.
Now look at him!
Cuban Assassin with the advantage and the strength right now, but Tommy Rich, resourceful, and freeing himself there, arm drag, taking the Cuban Assassin over. I'll tell you something, as Rich is preparing for his event with Lex Luger, if Luger is still the champion when this hour concludes. To wrestle a man with Luger's great athletic ability and power, you got to take him off his feet. Much like Tommy will have to do the Cuban Assassin here. Nice drop toe by the Assassin, floats over Rich, but Rich very quickly reverses the maneuver right into the hammerlock.
No.
Rich now has Cuban Assassin right where he wants him. As Assassin now tries to relinquish a little of the pressure by returning to the vertical base. Tommy maintains that arm bar. Tommy Rich is so mentally tough. You know, he lapsed into virtual obscurity in pro wrestling. Re-emerging here in the NWA to attempt to recapture that magic that he once truly possessed, especially here on the Superstation. And I, for one, believe he can do it. He really has his mind set in becoming the United States champion, or the world champion for that matter. That's everyone's ultimate goal in this sport. Good side headlock by Rich, taking the Cuban Assassin over. This Cuban Assassin also, very high threshold of pain. He's also got a handful of tights there, using it for leverage. This is a very important match here on national television, here on the Superstation, TBS. Our program is becoming extremely popular on Friday nights, and we certainly appreciate all the fans and their diligent efforts in tuning in, usually following the Atlanta Braves and enjoying the outstanding baseball in the National League. and then watching the NWA. We really appreciate you being with us here. I don't think we say that often enough. We certainly appreciate you allowing us to come into your homes once again and each and every weekend here on the Superstation. Side headlock there as Tommy Rich keeping the Cuban Assassin at bay. This match very methodical. Both men feeling each other out, basically. Nice tackle by Tommy. Goes to the rope for the momentum, but it was turned against him there. As the Cuban sidestepped, Tommy Rich sent him sailing out through the second and the third rope to the floor. I want to remind the fans, the NWA back in the Omni with a big back-to-school celebration. That's a week from this Sunday night in the Omni here in Atlanta. Big back-to-school celebration. I know the NWA, the great promoters, are planning on many back-to-school celebrations throughout the month of September. About that time, kids. Hate to remind you, Mom and Dad have done so. And the Assassin, that was a great move. Going downstairs with a headbutt, using his own head as a weapon. And Rich, look at Rich blocking this attempted vertical suplex and reversing the snap suplex. Tommy slow to roll on top of the big Cuban. That suplex took it out of Tommy as well. Cuban Assassin goes to the ride. Tommy Rich goes downstairs and buries the right hand. Back.